Hello, sports fans and baseball fans. I'm here today with a Strat-O-Matic game from the past, a game from back in the day. Not even an actual game that it was actually played, but it's between two teams from back in the day. We're going to have the 1907 Pittsburgh Pirates, who were 91-63-3. Three ties. That was back in the days, I guess, when they had ties. Against the 1944 Brooklyn Dodgers. And they were the opposite, almost the opposite. They were 63-91-1. So I am going to be taking the Pirates. Now, if you know, my track record isn't very good taking these games from back in the day. The team I take usually loses. But we'll see if that happens today. The Pirates were much better than the Dodgers, so we'll see if that happens in this particular game. Babe Adams will be pitching for me for the Pirates, and Chapman is going to be pitching for the Brooklyn Dodgers. Our lineup today will be Anderson in right field, Abitaccio at second, Honus Wagner at shortstop, Terry Leach in center, Fred Clark in left, Nealon at first base, Gibson at catcher, Storka, it looks like, at third base, and Babe Adams pitching. For the Dodgers, they'll go with Eddie Stanky at second base, Bragan at short, Walker in right, Galen in left, Schultz at first, Bordigari at third base, Almo in center, Owen at catcher, and Chapman pitching. Now, the one thing that might give the Dodgers an edge is that the 1907 season was one that wasn't marked by a lot of home runs. So the Pirates aren't going to be a team that's likely to hit homers. But by 1944, the home run had become more in vogue and was more common. So the Dodgers will be able to hit home runs probably at a more prolific pace than the Pittsburgh Pirates of 1907 are likely to. But anyway, we will get on with the game. And of course, the backdrop is Yankee Stadium because I didn't put in stadiums for the 1944 teams. So that's what the appearance is. And you can see you've got Goat Anderson pitching to, is that right? Goat Anderson pitching to Ben Chapman. Ben Chapman is up. Ben Chapman is pitching for them. Okay, I'm up. All right. I was a little thrown off there. So Abitaccio now is batting against Chapman, who got the first man out. And he's going to ground out second to Stanky. And that brings up Honus Wagner. Honus Wagner. And he is going to, is that a home run? After I just got done saying, hey, no, that was a fly out. So he's out and the Pirates go 1-2-3. And now you got Babe Adams on the mound for us pitching to Eddie Stanky of the Dodgers. And it looks like he's going to ground out to third. One down, and that brings up Bobby Bragan. And he, let's see if he gets a hit. Yep, that's a base hit. Got between the second baseman and the first baseman in the hole. So Dixie Walker is up with Bragan at first and only one out. And that's going to be a base hit. And that puts runners at the corners with Galen up and only one out. And really, Babe Adams, if you look at Babe Adams' card, it's not great. I was expecting a little better from Babe Adams. So you got Gale. What was that? Oh, I guess he picked him off. But that was a base hit, and that knocked in a run. So now you got Howie Schultz up with Galen at first base, getting the base hit, and Wagner looks like it's going to be a ground out. Also, another thing that's going to probably mark the 1907 Pirates versus the Dodgers is they're going to have a lot more errors. So anyway, Terry Leach is up against Chapman. We're down 1-0, top of the second.
Not surprising.
Given my track record in games like this. Fred Clark. Got Fred Clark up. And he is going to, it looks like, fly out to Galen. That's two down, and Jim Nealon is up. I think I went to high school with a kid named Jim. So Bordagari, I don't know how you pronounce that guy's name. But anyway, he's up against Babe Adams now that the Dodgers are at the plate and we're back in the field. And you can see some of these errors. You got Stork with 39 errors, Wagner 53, Abatechio 37, and the out, like Leach in center with 8, which is high for a center fielder. So anyway, that Bordagara is on with Almo up the plate and no outs. And was that a base hit? No. He's out and Mickey Owen is up. Mickey Owen, that was a pass ball, looks like. And Bordagara goes second. Looks like Owen is going to ground out to Owen. And that brings up Chapman, Ben Chapman, the pitcher. And he should be flying out to Anderson, and that will do it. So they don't get any more runs, and George Gibson is up against Ben Chapman. And he walks. Stork is up. Maybe we can get that one between in the hole. And it is. Let's say he got an infield hit. Runners at first and second, no outs. Babe Adams up. I will bunt. I don't like bunting. If you know me, I really do not like bunting, but I will do it here. I'm even going to stay with the bunt. And it's a strikeout. So Anderson's up, and that was probably what would have happened. You would guess something along those lines. But it looks like he hit it in the hole, though. I'm going to hold the runners, though. So the bases are loaded with Abatechio up and only one out. And that's a tie game. They walked Abatechio. Honus Wagner's up. Now, Honus Wagner, man, that guy, he needs to get a hit. And he does, right up the middle. And I'm going to send the lead runner, too. And it works, and we have a 3-1 lead with Terry Leach up. And that looks like it'll be a flyout. Yep, two down, and Fred Clark up with two runners on, two down. And he will probably ground out to short, and he does. But we took the lead. We're ahead 3-1. Babe Adams has a 3-1 lead now. Pitching to Stanky. Stanky gets a hit, though. Bragging up, I'm not going to watch Stanky. And that was a line out to third, one down, and Dixie Walker. And Dixie Walker is going to get a base hit. I am going to stop the runner from advancing. We have a two-run lead, so Galen up. And that looks like it's going to be maybe a double. Could be a double. Yeah. I'm going to throw for the lead runner. And did we get him? I don't think we got him, and it's a tie game. So it's tied up at 3 minutes. Second, Schultz with a probably double. Yep, Schultz gets a double, and now they've got a lead again. Up 4-3. This is not a good bet, I'll tell you that. Ground ball to Abitaccio. And that's going to be the second out. Runner at third, 90 feet away, with Olmo up the plate. And that could be a hit in the hole. And it is. And they score another run. So now they're ahead 5-3. And I thought we had done ourselves a favor getting three runs, but really it's not holding up right now. Babe Adams is really not pitching very well, and he doesn't have that great of a card. Jim Nealon up. Top of the fourth. We're up at the plate now, but we're down by two. When we were up by two, coming into this inning, to the last inning. And Jim Nealon gets a base hit. George Gibson is up at the plate. George Gibson's going to get a base hit, and I'm going to send the lead runner, because we got to do that. Stork up, runners at the corners, no outs. And that's probably going to get a run. And it does, but it's a double play. Costs us two outs to get that run, and then Babe Adams up. But now we're only down by one. A high scoring game so far. Adams strikes out, and he goes back out to the mound, and will deal to Ben Chapman, their pitcher. And he gets a base hit. Eddie Stanky is up. I'm not going to hold Chapman for sure. And that was a pass ball. Moves Chapman to second. And Stanky's out for the rest of the game. Bragan is up. Should be a ground ball to Wagner. And that is two down, and Dixie Walker at the plate, Chapman at second. And it looks like that's an out, and it is. So, we're down by one, top of the fifth. The score is 5-4 Brooklyn Dodgers ahead of the 1907 Pittsburgh Pirates. Goat Anderson up. And he walks. That's nice. Should I try to steal? I'm going to try to steal. And he does make it nice. Now Abitaccio up to plate. Man at second, no outs. And he's out and didn't advance anybody. Wagner at the plate. Let's see if they walk him. No, they're going to pitch to him. And he is out, and that brings up Terry Leach. And Terry Leach is struck out, and we don't get any runs, despite the fact we got a leadoff single and a man stole second. Now we're in the bottom of the fifth, still down by a run, and Babe Adams pitching horribly. And he continues to pitch horribly. That might be a flyout, let's hope. Yes, it is an out. So Howie Schultz up to plate. He is going to hit a double, it looks like. That's got double written all over it. Oh no, it was an out. He made the play. And Bordagari, he's out. Some of you older guys out there might know how to pronounce the name. Let me know how to pronounce it. Fred Clark is up to plate, top of the sixth. We're down by a run. And he's out. Kneeling up with one out. Nobody on. And that's strike three. And Gibson is up at the plate. And Gibson looks like he's got maybe a home. Is that a home run? No. That was an out. So we're still down by a run. Babe Adams still out there giving it his all, Olmo. And he spears it, so that's a line out. Mickey Owen up. Now all of a sudden nobody can score anything. All right, base between second and, or between short and third. On with Chapman up. They let Chapman hit, and he's going to, man, Chapman has been great offensively. Not all that great pitching, but he's been great offensively. Not going to bring in me. Oh, I did bring the infield in. And that looks like it's going to be something. It was a double. So now they're ahead. Now, yeah, now they're just taking off. That's two down and Dixie Walker up. He's 2-for-3 on the day. And he grounds out. No, it's in the dirt. It's an error. So Galen is up with runners at the corners. Brooklyn had 7-4. And they got him. So no runs. Stork is up. I'm going to pinch hit if the pitcher comes up, if Babe Adams comes up, because he's really been terrible. Stork is out and Babe Adams is up, and I am going to pinch hit for him. We've got Chapman on the mound. He's a righty who's a 2R, so we will put up Hallman, a left-handed batter. Well, let's see. McKechnie? Maybe McKechnie. No. Moeller? Yeah, we'll put up Moeller. We got to have a hit. And he's a lefty with a good average. Denny Miller. Moeller. Miller. I don't know what he had. Did he get something? No. It's probably going to be a fly out to center. So two down and go to Anderson up. He walks and Abitaccio is up. We need runs now, not just one, so I'm not going to try to steal. And he's out. So that takes us to the bottom of the, should be the bottom of the seventh. And I need another pitcher. We will put in Deacon Philippe. So Deacon Philippe pitching to Howie Schultz. We're down by three. Bottom of the seventh. 1944 Dodgers ahead of the 1907 Pirates. That could be a home run. No, he made the catch. So it's an out. Nice. Franchi Bordagari. There he is again. Bordagari. And that was a base hit. Louis Olmo is up, man at first, one down. That's going to be a pop out to Stork. And Owen is up. And Owen gets him. So I'm still down by three, and now I only got two innings to make that up. Honus Wagner is up. It's got to start with Honus Wagner, for sure. He's one for three with two RBIs. And did he get a base hit there? No. He lined out. Terry Leach is up. Or Tommy Leach. I keep calling him Terry Leach. He might have a double or a homer. No, it's caught at the wall. I was afraid that was going to happen. Fred Clark is up. We're down two outs here in the eighth. And he gets a double or a fill in an error or something. So now Nealon has to drive him home. And that was an out. So Chapman is up at the plate. Doesn't look like they're pinch hitting for him. Bottom of the eighth. But, well, I mean, why not? He's only given four runs to pretty good Pirate offense. That's an out. Coke is up. Barney Coke. Philippe has been pretty good in relief here. But we were down three runs when he came in, so got to make that up. So that's the Dodgers are out there in the eighth, and we go to the top of the ninth. We got to have three runs right here or the game is over. George Gibson up at the plate, first batter to face Chapman. And that's going to be a base hit. And Stork is up. And they keep Chapman in, and that might be, maybe we can get something. No, that's a double play, and Deacon Philippe is at the plate, and I am not going to hit Deacon Philippe, although it's really questionable that we're going to be able to come up with three runs. So we are going to go with the original plan back when I pinch hit before, and it'll be Hallman who will pinch hit for Deacon Philippe. And he walks, so go to Anderson. Hallman keeps us alive. And might that be, no, that's gonna be a fly out, it looks like, to center field. And that is the game. And again, my track record of being terrible managing, picking the team that happens to lose, continues. And the 1907 Pirates, who were much better than the 1944 Brooklyn Dodgers, nevertheless lose to the Dodgers 7-4. You can see the box score right there, and you can see for us, Adams went 6. He allowed 13 hits and 7 earned runs. It was terrible. Philippe went 2. He allowed only 1 hit and no runs. But Chapman went the distance for them, pitched 9, allowed 7 hits and 4 earned runs, striking out 8. So I hope you enjoyed that game. That's going to be it for me, Sportsman Z, Bob Zolke, signing off.